Starting a garden is one of the most rewarding things you can do, and everyone wishes to have a beautiful garden, but often end up with many questions prior starting it and finds the answer to all of them once started. To make it easy for you all to start growing, here is my effort to introduce few herbs that can be grown very easily as a beginner. So come, let's begin. So the first one in the list is our holy basil or tulsi. Tulsi is one of the best examples of Ayurveda's holistic lifestyle approach to health. It is said that daily consumption of tulsi prevents disease and promotes general health, well-being and longevity, and also assists in dealing with the stresses of daily life. Tulsi can be grown from the seeds collected from the previous crop or from the plants bought from the local nurseries. Since tulsi is a tropical plant, it is advised to keep your tulsi plant near the sides of your balcony where it gets at least 4 to 5 hours of sunlight. The next plant is Indian pennywort or Asiatic pennywort. It is also called as Saraswati, Satyavati, Smarini and Brahmacharini plant, as it is used in many problems concerning women. It is also used as a brain tonic and to control nerve disorders. The extract can be used for improving the voice and as a toner of heart muscle. It is recommended in leprosy, itching, fever, edema, respiratory ailments and anemia. It's easy to grow centella as it is extraordinarily versatile. The large stem can be cut into pieces having a node and can be grown. It is extraordinarily versatile and can be grown in the hanging basket as well. Remember to water regularly as the plant loves damp soil or loves to be in water. The next plant is the miracle aloe vera. Aloe vera is a succulent plant species of the genus Aloe. Aloe vera is being used extensively for the treatment of skin diseases and also for the constipation. It is loaded with antioxidants and antimicrobial properties. Aloe do best in dry conditions. When growing aloe vera, plant them in a potting mix which is very porous as it does not tolerate standing water. The soil of the aloe vera plant should be allowed to go completely dry before being watered. When the aloe vera plant is watered, the soil should be thoroughly drenched, but the water should be allowed to drain freely from the soil. It often produces young pups on and around the plant. You can separate the pup and grow it in a separate pot. Thus, you can easily multiply a aloe vera plant. Cacti family plants are fairly easy to propagate from cuttings, but aloe vera cuttings with their high moisture content really became viable plants. With the cutting method, the probability of getting rotten or shriveled leaf is more, so it is suggested to plant the offsets. The next herb is the Malabar spinach. It's a good source of protein, magnesium, phosphorus, potassium and also a rich source of antioxidant. It can be easily propagated from the stem cuttings and also be grown in a pot shade, which increases the leaf size. The next herb is the mint. It's a rich source of antioxidants and phytonutrients. It is also known to calm stomach cramps and helps beat acidity and flatulence. It is also used for the patient suffering from irritable bowel syndrome. The easy method to grow mint is given in the description box below. Please do check. They grow really well in the direct sunlight, but you can also try growing them in the partial sunlight in your balconies. As the plants grow rapidly, choose a pot which is 8 to 10 inches in diameter at least. The next herb is your amaranthus. The red amaranthus species is often used as edible leafy vegetable. Phytochemicals in amaranthus are good to control the high cholesterol level in your blood. This can commonly be grown with the seeds collected from the previous crop. The seeds can be dried and used to plant it in the next season. I hope this information would help you. So if you have any doubts, please let me know in the comment box below. Happy gardening!